Alright, quick video, take two. Did it the first time, I fucked it all up. Couldn't get this switched out on camera. So what am I going to talk about today? I'm going to talk about the G-Code Haley Strategic Joint Partnership for the Incog holster. So, I completely fucked this up, but I originally had it mounted on with a mag caddy so I could carry an extra magazine. And that mag caddy is right here. Well, you notice the mag caddy is no longer attached to the Incog mag caddy, but a Cobra paddle. So I was bitching one day to my buddy Champ, and he's way smarter than me about gun shit. And anywho, I was complaining that it's bulky, and sometimes I find myself leaving my G23 in my Incog at home because of the weight with the extra mag and the two clips and everything else. Two Incog clips. I would never refer to these as clips, merely as magazines. Just wanted to clear up that confusion. Anywho, so he's said, well, rip your mag caddy off and go down to only one of the Incog clips. So I guess that's a pretty cool idea. I worried about the retention and how solidly it would hold it, but I've been running it this way for about 2 months and I absolutely love it. It gives it a little bit of play, so when it sits on your belt, it kind of rotates just a little bit. So if you sit down or whatever, it just gives that little bit extra movement. Love it. Absolutely love it. I love it so much. I saw that the new Eclipse holster came out, which basically took off the second attachment point. And they have what's now called a Mojo clip that... basically, it attaches more or less at the same place, but it rotates over at an angle to sit more midline on the firearm to evenly distribute the weight. I was going to get the Eclipse clip. However, it's about $30 if you want the burnt orange one, which looks pretty sweet. But for $30, that's about half. That's exactly half the prices I paid for this, I think. I wasn't really interested in that when this works just as well. So, before I got this Cobra paddle, I was just throwing my extra magazine in my pocket. It's not a very effective way to run a mag. So, I called up G-Code. I explained my dilemma of what do I do. I have this Incog mag caddy, and I don't care for running it on the Incog. What can I do? And it was cool because, you know, I call this company and I don't know, I think like a lot of us are like, ooh, G-Code, they're super famous. And when you call and you pick up the phone and somebody answers on the third ring and you explain your dilemma and they're like, yep, this is what you need to order, this is where you find it, and it'll work real well for you. It just made me a believer in G-Code. They didn't act inconvenienced at all that I was calling to ask stupid questions and that I couldn't find the answer on my own, so... Bravo to them. So, I really like this. It's a nice paddle. It doesn't add any bulk to it, really. And I only wore it a few minutes just to make sure I installed it correctly. And, yeah, I really like it. So, if you have an Incog and you think maybe it's a little too bulky, run it, especially with the mag caddy. This Cobra paddle was only, like, $9. It was... pretty darn inexpensive. It's probably the cheapest thing I've ordered this month for gun related stuff. And then I still got this, so I don't know what I'm going to do with it, but yeah. But anyway, so if you don't like running your Incog the way you have it, peel one of the Eclipse off of it and run your extra mag caddy and a paddle. Boom.